Hello everybody, welcome to Dental Academy USA. My name is Leo Kirish and I'm here straight from my office in North Carolina to share a little bit of knowledge about how to become a dentist in the United States. I'm bringing a few interesting questions that I get from folks from all over the world, and here in this YouTube channel, you're gonna be able to browse through and find many, many answers that you might be looking for. Let's see what's the question of the day. All right, so the question of the day is about the dental board exam. People have asked me, with the new format, how is this gonna change between two parts to one part integrated? What is the difference? Well, the main difference now, you don't have to pay two fees to pass the exam. That's one of the main differences. But at the end of the day, it's still a very long exam. It's still gonna take you 2 days to take the full exam. And you have to study a lot. That's not going to change. But from several folks that have taken the exam in the last 2 years and I have talked to, some people even took the part one and then they took the integrated, or they took the part one, passed, part two, failed, and then they took the integrated part. What I hear are these things. Let's go one by one. Number one, it seems that the exam is focused a little bit more on the clinical things rather than a lot of theory. There's still a lot of theory stuff there, but they're putting a lot of clinical cases, you know? That's one thing. Number two, on part one, the previous exam, there was a lot of focus on biochemistry and some other stuff that is basic science, let's put that way. While in the integrated, I see people commenting a lot of things that are directly dentistry related, let's put that way, you know? Not as much as Krebs cycle in biochemistry and more stuff about dentistry. That's another thing. Number three, a lot of clinical scenarios. They will present to you a clinical scenario and they will have several questions about that clinical scenario, which is very, very interesting. Number four, there seems to be a more focus on dental related things rather than general health. And when I say that, it's not necessarily not thinking about general disease and stuff like that, because that has a lot still in the exam. But for example, if you want to study anatomy, instead of studying anatomy of your leg or something like that, your focus should be on head and neck anatomy, okay? That should be your focus. When you're studying physiology, instead of spending hours understanding how the lungs and hearts work, you probably should focus on something head and neck. That's another thing that I heard people talking about. Because when it was part one and part two, they could put a ton of questions in the exam because there are two parts. Now with one part only, they had to reduce the amount of questions and the focus seems to be more on more dental related stuff. But don't forget that there's like several systemic diseases that affect teeth, and you're certainly gonna find stuff like that in the exam. Syndromes and all kinds of stuff, you're still gonna find that. But when it comes to like physiology, anatomy, and some other things like this, you probably wanna focus more on head and neck rather than full body. These are a few things I wanted to bring it to you. There's of course a lot more, it's a very long exam, but this is supposed to be a short video with a few tips about the integrated national board dental exam. I know that a lot of people dread to take this exam, but for foreign trained people especially, the fact that they integrate and put in one part only, it makes it a little bit easier because we don't have to go back to the very, very, very basic science to study that, because most of us, we're done school, it's been a few years out, and we don't check these things on a regular basis, but we do see teeth on a regular basis, we do see patients on a regular basis. So my understanding, I didn't take the INBDE, I took part one and two, but my understanding, especially from those folks who did part one or part one and two separately, failed on the part two and then took the integrated, my understanding is that the integrated boards was easier than the part one. Not necessarily the part two, but the part one. I hope this helped you guys. My name is Leo Kirish. Like, share, drop a comment here. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and I'll keep bringing some interesting videos to you guys.